So it's amazing to even think right now, right? Just to even think about it, to wrap your head around, how could the SMHs be up over 20% and the video can't get on this channel? That's mind-boggling.
Welcome to Access a Trader, the number one community for those who are committed to taking control of their trading in order to achieve success, profitability, and longevity. Thank you for joining us. Here's Dan Shapiro to help you find your edge, master your process, and own your future.
Hey guys, good morning everybody. Welcome to another edition of the AccessOfTrader.com Weekend Update Show. Hope everybody is doing well. Hope everybody's having a good start to the weekend. Raining outside here in New Jersey. Again, we're living in a COVID world. You throw in some winter behind it, you throw in some rain, you got to try to stay very mentally tough because, again, life is always trying to, try you, right? You're going to be put into a lot of adverse situations, both trading, your personal life. You got to be mentally strong. You got to keep that mind working. You have to, kind of take yourself always to that happy place because, again, mental health is incredibly important. And just like myself and everybody else, nobody's immune to tough mental times. You feel like you're sitting there and your walls are closing in and, there's just like there's no area that you can see some goodness, some light at the end of the tunnel. But again, there always is. And it's easier said than done. But we really have to be kind of better friends to ourselves, kind of put ourselves in a situation that we're trying to keep ourselves active. We're trying to keep ourselves happy. Always think of the good thoughts, right? Don't dwell on the small things in life that when they compound, don't become small anymore. All of a sudden become big. And again, it's a very, very tough time, especially towards the holidays for a lot of people. But again, just know somebody out there always loves you. Always remember that. You're never alone. Things are never as worse as you think they are. You always have somebody in your side, whether you realize it or not, that can help you. And that's both in your personal life and in your trading life as well. So keep the faith, especially if you're a new trader and this is your first year. And again, you see the stock market going absolutely nuts and you see a lot of people doing well. But just remember, they're doing this for a very, very long time. This is a very, very majestic market, very exaggerated. Again, like we say all the time, it's going to end one day, right? This big exaggerated run. But again, right now, let's try to enjoy it as much as possible. But just always have in your mind, okay, that this is going to be something that you will remember and take really full appreciation for when things start slowing down and you start seeing channels contract. So maybe that $15 stock that you buy won't go to $17 in 45 minutes. Maybe it'll go to $15.50, but at least you'll be in control of your trading and that market will start to really discipline you as a trader. But for now, enjoy the ride, right? Enjoy the ride. Market is incredibly aggressive. Right now, if you look at the scoreboard, it really doesn't really paint a picture how good the market is. Again, you could turn around and say, look, NASDAQ's up 2%, the Dow and S&P up 1% as well. But again, it doesn't matter. There's no fear. Even if we saw when we saw the back test coming, I think it was Wednesday or Thursday, on the Wednesday video, I said, nobody's even going to notice the back test. And did anybody really even notice when the Qs back tested back to the 5-day moving average? And that's kind of the whole point, and that's kind of the good sign of how strong the market is. Again, right now, if you are a beta trader, and there's nothing wrong with them individually, and if you've been watching kind of this broadcast, even for the last 30 days, you kind of know there's something wrong with the beta stocks. Amazon, went on that one big run for 2 days and has pretty much given back pretty much all its gains. Facebook had that one big run out of the channel, if you guys remember, on Monday and literally closed below the channel. Something's definitely wrong. NVIDIA, I've been literally scalping now for, you can see how NVIDIA has been going sideways now, literally since November the 10th. I've been literally scalping this thing off ranges. But again, if you watch like every video, I'm saying to myself, how can this thing still not erupt with all these stocks kind of rotating into a big move? And again, look at the long distribution in NVIDIA. And I'm still sitting there every day saying, maybe today's the day, maybe today's the day, maybe today's the day. Still waiting. Apple had that one big run, right? Had that one big run. It's doing a really good job of distribution. But you'd figure with again, such strength in the market, Apple would just be really putting in a stairway to heaven. So a lot of wrong things are going on in beta land, which is very, very odd. Zoom, again, you can make an argument. Zoom is down again. Reason, well, number one, earnings were baked in. Everybody knew they were going to come out with great earnings. They had a 480% rise year over year in revenue or profits from businesses with 10 employees or more. But everybody knew that. I mean, this was, again, the biggest beneficiary of the whole stay-at-home movement. This wasn't really a shock. The question was what was going to happen next. And now that the vaccines are rolling out slowly but surely, that people are going to start taking them, you know, the question is, you know, what can the stock do next? What can the company do next to kind of innovate itself, to take itself higher? Does it go away? Absolutely not. I know pretty much everybody knows somebody who uses Zoom. I use Zoom. It's a phenomenal product. But again, is it, where's the next innovation? Where's the next play on potential? So that's very, very important. Netflix, again, like another perfect example on beta that, again, it looks like it's about to go, right? It wants to go. It feels like it go. You're starting to get a lot of option flow on the name. We had that big, big channel confirmation on Tuesday and did nothing for the rest of the time. Again, you can make it, you know, you can make a decision and say, well, the stock is just resting. Yeah, that's the whole point. They're resting. They had that big initial move and then they're resting. So again, does it need to take out this channel? Absolutely. But again, it's playing the same way as a lot of names. Everybody and their mother is waiting on Tesla. I think, again, does anybody not think it's going to test the top of this channel here? It's just imminent. You can see every single day bigger and bigger option flow come in. Every single time it comes in the bottom of the channel here, you can see it hits the bottom of the channel, spikes, hits the bottom of the channel, spikes. So it's not the question of if it's going to challenge this channel here, is just when. And every single day, we're just waiting for that as well. So if you are trading on the beta side, you know, you're getting good moves throughout the week, but you're getting them one, you know, one at a time, like literally one trade at a time. And then you're sitting there for 2 days later waiting for something else to pop. And again, that's the game. And unfortunately, if you kind of fix yourself on one group or one type of tribe, you know, you're going to be shut out. Luckily, we're in the market right now that you can see the valuable rotation with the SPAC names and the EV names and the Dow stocks. Look, I mean, look how great the Dow stocks have been acting. Boeing had a monster pivot this week. Congratulations for all you guys who caught it. We talked about this 223 pivot in nausea. I mean, look at the, you know, 2 day move, went to 242, huge move. We talked about Marriott for several days. You know, Marriott finally broke out above this 132 channel, and Honeywell, right? If you guys have been watching this, you know, broadcast for the last, you know, week or so, we've been waiting for that 210, right? 210 on Honeywell as well. So, had almost a $3 move. So you could see the Dow stocks acting very, very well. You could see names non-beta acting very, very well. Names that I would never trade, I'm trading right now because, again, it's very, very easy to sit here and just say, oh, woe is us. You know, you're not getting a full rotation to beta. But there's so many other names, and we'll get into the individual pivots in a second, that are doing so well. Again, are these stocks going to be my focal point when beta goes full, you know, full power mode? No, absolutely not. But for now, you know, they're really good focus of subsidized income. They're really good, strong moves. You're getting a lot of aggressive call buying on non-traditional names. And again, you just have to roll with it. Like I said in a couple of videos prior, again, you don't need to overthink right now. There's no materialistic reason the market needs to get destroyed. Again, will it one day? It's inevitable. Okay, every bull market ends. We've been talking about the caution side, playing devil's advocate all the time. Again, your money is not safe. Your money is just there, and so it's your job to keep it. So it's very, very important to acknowledge that every bull market will eventually end. But again, like I said a few minutes ago, let's enjoy the ride, but be conscious what potentially could happen, and just don't overthink. The dips are still being bought. If you look at levels, the Qs, until we start closing below the five-day moving average, you have to assume the market continues. And you can see here the last three times, right? We hit the five-day, we bounce. We hit the five-day, we bounce. We hit the five-day, we bounce. So again, until we close below the five-day moving average, you should have an opinion that we are still going higher. The IWM that rested for, you know, for a week. You know, we talked about the top of the channel here, 184.5. For a full week, and again went higher. And diamonds finally took out that 301 level, and it went higher. So macro-wise, we're good. Structurally, we're good. This is a really good stock picker's market. But again, you still have to be intelligent in your approach. You can't just buy a stock that's up 200% in 2 days. That's not the value. Again, you know, in this type of environment, when I sat down initially Friday night to start looking at preliminary chart, I mean, every chart looked like a stairway to heaven. It's harder and harder every single day to find that base, right? To find that value of a stock sitting there in a 6, 7, 8, two-week channel that's ready to come out. A lot of names in orbit. Luckily for the beta names, well, that's not them. So when you look at, for example, on the beta side, you know, like a booking.com, right? I still don't understand the name. Like, why would you change the name from Priceline to Booking? Every single time I see the symbol, I think of Burger King. Am I the only one that sees BKNG and says Burger King? But, you know, you could see, you know, booking.com or Priceline, whatever the hell you want to call it. This thing looks like it's about to come out of a channel, right? So that looks good. You look at Las Vegas Sands, for example. Again, this is what we talk about, trying to find value in a market that's a stairway to heaven. You know, this looks good, right? Marriott broke out this week. Las Vegas Sands, you know, is sitting in a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19-day distribution, right? It's almost, you know, almost a full month of trading. Once it comes out of the channel, it should go as well. So there's still value in the markets. That's 100%. But when you look at where the strength lies in the last month or so, you know, if you look at the semiconductors, just, you know, you're talking about a 20-25% move just in the last month. So it's amazing to even think right now, right? Just to even think about it, wrap your head around, how could the SMHs be up over 20% and NVIDIA came out of this channel? That's mind-boggling to me. It just doesn't even make sense. But again, we trade the market we have, not the market we want. Eventually, everything will wake up. So, you know, going into this week, how can you not be continue to be bullish? But your job right now is try to find the ones with the biggest value. Try to find the ones that are not overextended. Like, for example, like a Gilead, right? Everybody's forgot about Gilead. Gilead has done nothing for the last, what, since summertime, right? Gilead was gone from $79 all the way down to like 57. But look, this could be a value trade, right? It's just settling here, going sideways. You see the supply here that it's rejected several times. If it could just start reclaiming supply, then you do have a $3-4 potential in a name like that. So again, your job right now is to find the value. Your job is not to buy a stock that just has gone from $6 to $37 and trying to flip it for 50 cents on a $30 push. This just doesn't make sense. That's the hard part of this market. That's where the grown-up trader, the more experienced trader, is going to have a bigger problem finding that kind of diamond in the rough when everything is already absolutely going nuts. But again, that's the game we play. And for me, the joy, any type of satisfaction from this business is not from the monetary side. It's like a puzzle, right? I've been saying this all the time. It's the research side. It's almost like a game that you're trying to find that the next great one, the next big hit. And for me, it's all about, you know, seeing where I can find that value and where I can take advantage that nobody's even looking at. So names like a Las Vegas Sands, I'll be watching. Names like a Booking.com, I'll be watching. A name like Gilead, I'll be watching. Even a stock like Paychex, right? Look at Paychex as well. Again, not a traditional name, but I would look at. But again, look at the long distribution. So there's still value out there, okay, despite the runaway train the market has had. But the point is, again, we have to be disciplined enough to wait for these things to play out. And the most important part is, again, when they're there, again, take advantage of the market scenario. We are very, very strong, and these things have a high probability to continue. So let's talk about Friday's session. Overall week has been really good, really, really good. Thursday, from now till the end of the year, by the time Thursday rolls around, for all you guys who are not in the live webinar, I'm literally trading and speaking and broadcasting for the whole day. So I'm speaking 7 hours a day. I mean, it's just incredibly mentally tough. So by the time like Thursday afternoon rolls around, I'm a vegetable. I'm exhausted. So Thursday night, for the next 3 weeks until the new year, I'm going to take Thursday nights off of not recording the video, because again, I'd rather be mentally ready for Friday session just than be completely burnt out. Again, especially materialistically, nothing has changed in the markets. For me to come out on Thursday night saying the market continues to be good, yeah, we get it. The market's pretty good. So again, this is kind of my point of being a better friend to yourself. Learn to take some downtime to kind of recharge the batteries, because again, in this COVID world, we really have to be creative to kind of be a better friend to ourselves. So kind of going forward for the next 3 weeks, I'm just going to take Thursday nights off. So let's talk about Friday's session. Really aggressive. I think that's the best way of saying it. Congratulations, you guys. I've gotten tons of emails in the last 12 hours or so. Great. I mean, listen, the market's good. I mean, what are you going to say? The market's really good. If you've been trading for a long time, you kind of really appreciate how good it is. And yes, I have to admit right now, we're there with the internet craze. We really are. If it's not as good as the internet craze, it's pretty damn close, and that's really saying a lot. So let's talk about Friday's session. Pretty orderly, very aggressive. Let's take it one by one. I really like this GBT short. It hasn't confirmed yet. So 43.50, 43. If it builds below, can flush. So look at this chart on GBT, guys, and keep an eye on this thing for this week. So this stock is in a dead downtrend, right? It gapped down. I forgot what this news is. It doesn't really matter. So it rallied back, and it got rejected off the supply. You see how many times it's kind of holding on this 10-day moving average, right? If this 10-day moving average snaps and it closed below, guys, look how much room this thing has. It stopped rallying. As the market's going higher, it completely stopped rallying. If this thing could just close below this rising demand, guys, look how much room you have. So I really like this thing for this week, assuming it confirms. Honeywell, again, if you've been watching this broadcast for the last week, 210 continues to be a big spot. Here was Honeywell. Some of you guys are still swinging this thing. Really, it looks really good. Finally took out the 210. Closed just under 213. It has room here to the 215 area this week. So good job for all you guys who are still in Honeywell. Ironically, this was one of my bigger trades of the day. Yala, of all things. And it's one of the more fun symbols. Like, I literally said, every single time it was going up, I was just screaming, Yala! Right? You guys remember, like, Yahtzee, that board game Yahtzee? Yala! Really fun to trade. So we got long on the $15 break. It confirmed on the 1570. Look at this. I mean, only in a market like this can a stock do this, which is amazing. So here was the 15. That was the previous day's high. Here was the 1565, 1570. The damn thing went to 18 bucks. Just, again, only in this type of market. And as far as I know, I don't even know what the hell the thing does. But does it really matter, right? Does it really make a difference what fundamentals are in this type of tape when speculation money continues rolling? Absolutely phenomenal move on Yala. I still like the ZS, okay? ZS had a really big move a couple of days ago. I put in an inside day, which is resting, okay? It rested on a third of the volume. I think if it starts confirming Friday's channel, starts seeing the top of this channel very, very soon. Maybe just rest one more day, but I still like ZS. Never cracked there. Snow is by far the biggest mover of the day. And I can't even say by far. Yala was amazing, and FSLY, we'll get to that in a second as well. But again, here's a perfect example of option flow. Option flow comes in. The previous channel gets taken out, 343, 344 needs to build. Again, experienced traders only. The stock is not really for everybody, but you know, it takes out the 343, 344, and basically goes to 400. We saw 380, 390, 400, 500 call buyers step in. Again, the options market, and this is why we always reiterate, please get, you know, if you trade, especially momentum names, you have to have an option scanner just to see where the money flow is going into. And they ran this thing. I mean, to say ran is an understatement. This thing went from 343 to almost 400. Just a disgusting move, right? Just an absolute disgusting move. Shaq, nice breakout on Shaq's 87 needs to build. Shake Shack, right? Shake Shack. Again, I personally think their burgers are a little overrated. Just one man's opinion. But again, overall, again, pretty clean pocket here. Took out the 87, ran to like 88 and change. Still looks higher. Shake Shack, you know, nice move. Again, nice move on Shake Shack. FSLY just absolutely went bananas. Okay, absolutely went bananas. I caught this trade pretty decent. FSLY, we started watching early. We covered the stock a few times. 87.50 was like the 50-day supply. 87 was a sneaky channel. What was interesting about the FSLY pivot early on, when you saw the stock around 86 and change, wasn't really a lot of volume, okay? And that was kind of the key to a lot of names Friday morning. But then one guy comes in for the 87.50 weeklies. They're like, all right, you know, not bad. Nothing really exciting, but okay, not bad. And then 15 minutes later, a guy comes in for the 90s, right? 87.50 doesn't really get your attention. But when a guy is coming in for the 90 weeklies, then you start paying attention, and you started looking at the order flow, and it started coming in literally one by one, right? So here was the 87, right? It was 87 to 50 day, the 87.50 confirmation, and you started seeing order flow come in for the 90, the 95 weeklies, like one after another. We saw 100 weekly come in, and then next thing you know, it takes out that 87, takes out the 87.5, and this is one of the biggest moves I can remember In a long, long time from a non-beta traditional name. The stock literally went from 87 to 87.5, all the way to, you know, 90, you know, $97. I mean, that's how extreme this market is. Again, it's incredible to watch. And if this is your first year trading, it's not normal, right? This is exaggeration via dot-com era. It's not normal. But again, just suck it up. Enjoy it while it lasts. Because again, eventually the market shrink. It's not going to do that anymore, but just phenomenal, absolutely phenomenal move. And this is kind of what we started talking about, the option order flow. The January 500 buyer comes in, just nuts. Yala went absolutely nuts, 212 on deck. And I kept on saying, I thought, for example, 89, you know, like I made some sales in the 88.50s, and I was like, man, 89 is supply. You can't assume it's going to go beyond that, and it just went up another $8. So just crazy moves, right? And Yala's, you know, just everything went nuts. And I'm like, well, I'm now waiting for Tesla. Tesla didn't confirm just yet, but again, I think any day is imminent there as well. I still like Netflix, but you know, it's kind of disappointing, like everything else. It's, you know, it's had that big one day wonder and just not doing anything since. Nvidia again, not doing anything since. ZM, not doing anything since. And you know, it's funny joke, and one of the people asked me, he goes, if SLY is it going to stop today? My answer is no, obviously sarcastic. So, you know, again, the market continues to be great. Again, the challenge every single day is definitely to, you know, to keep your composure and just understand that this market will not last forever. But at the time, we have to kind of strike while the iron's hot, but at least be conscious that any potential day could be the last. So again, stay confident, stay poised, always play devil's advocate, always think safety first. Again, guys, be a better friend to yourself. If you could be a good neighbor to somebody else. Again, we're human beings. You know, this is one life to live. There's no reason to be salty or upset all the time. Learn to smile, be a good person. It really doesn't take a lot of energy, a lot of, you know, it doesn't take a lot of effort to be, you know, a good human being. Just do your part. God bless everybody. Have a great, amazing weekend, holiday season, and God willing, I'll see you all on Monday. Take care.